the history of Microsoft. The year was 1983. Sally Ride, age 32, was the first U.S. woman astronaut in space. The final episode of MASH aired with over 120 million viewers, and Kodak produced 8 million disc cameras during the first year of production. But the year 1983 proved to be one of dramatic changes for Microsoft. On February 18th, Paul Allen resigned as Microsoft's executive vice president, but remained on the board of directors. A few weeks later, on March 9th, 1983, Microsoft introduced MS-DOS 2.0. Now, as they rolled into the month of May, Microsoft introduced the Microsoft Mouse. It was a low-cost handheld pointing device for use with the IBM PC as well as any other MS-DOS-based personal computer.
I mean, for the first time, we hired a salesperson, and we hired a finance person, and so we had some new categories of skill that were things that I had essentially done, but that were more demanding now. We hired in Vern Rayburn to run this consumer products effort to, you know, think about packaging and pricing and promotion and how to get those things out there. And he hired quite a few people in to help him work on that area. So the development group, which has always been sort of the core of Microsoft, there it was the same kind of person coming on board, but the company had more aspects. In fact, we started our activities in Japan and in Europe, and so we were getting people in many different places, even though development we kept all here in Seattle. Our hiring was always focused on people right out of school. We had a few key hires like Charles Simone that came in with experience, but most of our developers, we decided we wanted them to come with clear minds, not polluted by some other approach, and learn the way that we liked to develop software and put the kind of energy into it that we thought was key.
On November 29th, 1983, Microsoft shipped its full-featured word processing program, Word, for MS-DOS 1. And provided a free demonstration copy to subscribers of the PC World Software Review. A few months later, Microsoft Press, a trade book publishing division specializing in computer books, was formed. Microsoft Press expected to publish 30 to 35 books in its first year. And the products just kept coming. And in November 1983, Microsoft unveiled Windows, an extension of the MS-DOS operating system that provided a graphical operating environment. Now, Windows featured a window management capability that allowed a user to view unrelated application programs simultaneously. It also provided the capability to transfer data from one application program to another. Windows wouldn't actually ship until 2 years later. As the year came to a close, the first international subsidiaries to connect to Microsoft email were in Europe, including the UK, France, and Germany. In 1983, the world population was 4.6 billion. The median household income was roughly $20,000, and the cost of a first-class stamp, 20 cents. But could the company continue its success with the absence of co-founder Paul Allen? Well, only time would tell.